worries and listen to me, listen to me. If you neglected to visit the war room, you don't know what you missed. Evangelists, we've been in a war room. The war room opened when we opened the convention, and we only closed it at 12 noon so everybody could be in the closing service. But we've been praying around the clock for 72 hours, believing God that God was going to do some stuff that could not be done by man. If you brought it in the war room, it's over. Somebody shout over. I'm sorry, but I came to church with a vendetta today. I'm vindictive today. I came with a vendetta against the devil. I don't like him, and I don't like what he does to the saints. And some saints are not wise concerning him and his devices. And so they let him use them. But I told him it's over. The thing that blessed me during this war room is that God spoke a word and he said he was taking the young and the mature. And he was going to allow a collision. And he was going to bring a revolution by merging both groups. Oh, you better hear me. You can't wait. I told you Thursday night, we must train our daughters. And what blessed me was those young women were crying out to God in that war room. My God, my God. I want to know that they can cry out. I don't want to wait till trouble comes. But I want to know that they know how to cry out. So thank you. I want to thank again Missionary Nicole Ward and her team for the great things that they did for the war room, and Missionary Sigel Schaefer and Missionary Marianne Cooper, who took that initiative on. And if you didn't put your request on the wailing wall, you missed it. You missed it. You got to believe God. And so I just thank God for all that has taken place.